At the Bedfont Hotel on Clacton's seafront, the day begins slowly. Visitors sleep while staff prepare for the busy day ahead. But these are special holiday visitors, for at this hotel, each of them is a spastic. The morning toilet may need the assistance of willing helpers, but the demand for food is just as real as at any other hotel. The Bedfont has four kitchen staff to cater for its 19 guests. Sponsored by the National Spastic Society, this is the only hotel in the country catering for unaccompanied spastic visitors. Breakfast time sees the guests ready and willing to do full justice to the tasty menu provided. Over 18,000 meals are served each year by the helpful staff. The main attraction of any seaside holiday is the beach, and the Bedfont, with its proximity to the sea, is in an ideal position to cater for this need. It even has its own beach hut, where visitors can relax in the sun. Fancy a paddle? And why not? If you don't like the walk, willing hands transport you in style. For a wheelchair spastic, a dip in the sea is one of the few possible relaxations. Even after a good rub down, it's still a bit nippy, and thoughts turn to lunch back at the hotel. regular visits by the hotel's own minibus to nearby beauty spots are a feature of holidays at the Bedfont. Bound to her wheelchair, Winnie earns her own living by making aprons. Hillary and Tony attend the same day centre. Tony is a leader there, in spite of being crippled from birth. Harry, on the back row, severely handicapped, is a wrestling fan. At Stratford, right in the heart of countryside made famous by the paintings of Constable, an artist pays no attention to the new arrivals, so accustomed to their visits have the local people become. The Bedfont would like to raise money for a larger coach so that more visitors could be transported at one time. There is also talk of a heated swimming pool costing £6,000 to be raised from voluntary subscriptions. While his friends feed the friendly ducks, Tony has bought a memento of his visit. In the evenings, the full social round begins. Theatres, wrestling, cinemas, a visit to the local, or a stay at home with the other guests. Michael types his letter home. Despite his severe handicap, his prize-winning hobby is embroidery. At the end of the day, Mrs. Molyneux, warden of the Bedfont, works on her accounts. The 10 guineas per week charged for each adult does not cover the running costs, and a yearly subsidy of £12,000 has to come from the Spastic Society. Yet, as the guests concentrate on their bingo session, who can doubt that this is money well spent? The happiness of the visitors in this holiday hotel, equipped for their pace and their limitations, must be sufficient justification for its continued existence.